What's up, everybody? It's Sparrow with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on Witness Wednesdays. When we left off in the last episode, we're still trying to tinker away at our second-to-last obelisk, and it's going pretty well. Let's see, we've got 5 puzzles left, it looks like. And this one has me a little bit perplexed. I believe this might actually be where we were in the last episode with the shadow walkway puzzles, especially considering that most all of these other ones were kind of in that general area. Like, this one, I forget where that one was, but I know, I think it's this one, and maybe that one, I forget, but I know 2 to 3 of these were all on that one L catwalk, so I'm wondering if this one isn't the same. But in order to not go back to the same place, we're going to actually look at a little bit of a different area today. One of them being the greenhouse, which I think this is what's being referenced as the greenhouse, this thing with the flower area. I've actually had 2 different people mention this, and they're being very courteous and trying not to, like, hey, go here, look this way. But because there's been multiple suggestions to kind of poke my head around in this area, lends some credence to the theory. So it's making me wonder, what am I missing here? Now, before we go and do that, I do want to take a gander at some of the puzzles just to kind of get a refresher on which ones are which and what I'm looking for. Because partially, I'm curious, because these aren't directly pointing towards the greenhouse area. I think that's the greenhouse, anyway. They're kind of, well, I guess maybe they are. I guess maybe they are kind of important. I always kind of assumed that was the mountain, but that might actually be pointing more towards the greenhouse, so that could be exactly what's going on. Actually, yeah, that's becoming more and more of a possibility to me. I thought the direction was a little wrong there, but, and I could kind of see this being an outline of a building, or this following the shapes of the flowers or something, too. Definitely worth investigating, so we are going to investigate. Now, the other thing I'm not sure about is where I need to be. So glad this game doesn't let you fall off cliffs, that would just be terrible. Because I don't know. Wait a minute. For a second there, that doorway was a little round. Because there's a couple of things you could do with this, like, for example, the colors could, in fact, be puzzles in the windows. You know, that's why I said this looked a little round, was if you could get a spot where all the colors lined up. I actually could see these turning into, like, the windows becoming puzzles. But, like I said, the biggest problem with this is I'm not really sure where the position is that I'm looking for. Is this open still? Okay, good. That looks like a thing. Okay, so this has to do with when the door is shut, I think. Or maybe? That's a thing. That is a thing right there. Because there's the end point, and there's... But I'm wondering, what happens if we... Can we not turn that off? Okay. So I guess that's kind of a, once it's there, it's there. Interesting. Okay, I'll probably have to be in there, in that room, in order to do a full color filter overlay is probably what's going on. Oh, I hate these places, they hurt my eyes. Okay, but now I'm not in a... Oh, wait. I was gonna say I'm not in the right position to see the circle. That may change if I'm up higher, though. Like that. Booyah! Alrighty. Well, there's one, so that solves that one, because that totally was what we were looking for. Now, the other question is where the next one is. Oh, man, I really apologize for these episodes. I hate these lights. They're hard on my eyes. I don't know why, but they're just hard to look at. These puzzles honestly could be anywhere. I wasn't really even focused on environmental when I was trying to solve these. So they literally could be anywhere in here. I am wondering if there isn't one outside, either around the building or on top of the building or something to that effect. But I have learned my lesson that sometimes this game can make you think a little bit too big. And what I mean by that is it's like, ah, it's an environmental puzzle, so it must take up the entire building, and like that, it's actually a doorway, you know. So there is something to be said about kind of maintaining your awareness of how large is something. And it could also be the reason why this ledge is here. We've talked about that before, where I was like, what is the point of this? It could be something like this. But I don't really know, because I don't see the shape that I'm looking for. And I think the shape's going to involve both layers of the building. I really think it's going to be both this and this. Because the pattern on the obelisk almost looked like it was going around... like, it could have been going around where the flowers were. We did this one already. I'm still not 100% sold that was all there was to this one, though. Like, it's possible that is also the starting point for the other two. Except for, I think it's on a different side than, that obelisk. And we still haven't found a reason for that gray cloud that we turned white. I'm wondering if that may not be the focal point of the other puzzle that we're talking about. The other two on the obelisk that we hadn't found, that they almost looked like mirrored shapes, in that you could go left or you could go right, or start from a different side kind of thing, but you'll end up with the same thing, is kind of what I'm thinking. And this spot has always been suspicious to me, you all know this. But like I said, I'm still not really seeing the pattern that I'm supposed to, I don't think. So it may be internal, it may be another inside that area puzzle. Before we check out on that theory, though, I probably should go all the way up to the top just to get a really high perspective. Because there have been times where if you're elevated high enough, you can see kind of what you're looking for. But unfortunately, I'm just not seeing the shape. Or more importantly, I'm really not seeing the start and end point. That's really what I'm looking for, and I don't see any circles or ends or anything like that. I have always wondered if there was a way to put a filter over these, though, from some perspective or angle. Just because that area deals so much with color filters, that I've always wondered if there's like a leaf or a, you know, some kind of hollow screen or something that's been disabled, and when you happen to look at it right, you know, it ends up doing its thing. I still think, you know, it's possible that other puzzle that I saw that I mentioned was probably back over here with these. It's possible it's this one with the two hands. It's possible that's the puzzle that I'm looking at for that. I still haven't figured that one out. Yeah, that's another interesting dilemma of... Now, this is also a curious thing of why this is here, too. I've always suspected that there was something going on with this walkway, because it lets you come out here, and we've just seen how filtering stuff can affect the way things look. So it is possible that it's actually in here somewhere, but I'm not... Unless it's like lining up the flowers correctly, which is possible. But I'm not really seeing it yet, but I do think it might be there. Just because when you move around certain ways, it starts to form kind of a shape if you look at it just right. I think we're on to something with this. I'm still not getting quite the right angle that I need, but I think it's a start. I think we're on the right track with that. I think this is the right location for it. I've just got to get it to form the right pattern. But it almost felt more vertical than that, the puzzle-wise, on the obelisk. It felt like there was a bit more verticality in it somewhere. Let's run back over and give it a peek again. So yeah, we're kind of drawing closer to like wrapping things up as far as I apologize if the last few videos have been a little monotonous for some. Yeah, I don't know. It kind of works with the flowers, but at the same time, that almost looks a little too vertical for the flowers, so I'm not really sure about that one. But this is what I was talking about with the mirror images. It almost looks like they're the same puzzle, just flipped. Which makes me wonder. Okay, it's over that-a-way somewhere. So that's not really what we're looking at. But this one is over here. Where is that hand in relation to it? Yeah, see, it does cross right about into that direction, so it totally could be that one. I just have to find the right perspective, because that's a puzzle. It has to be. I'm giving up on the paranoia theory. That's gotta be one. There's no way that there isn't some kind of perspective puzzle involved there when you've got two statues that look relatively unconnected, and then when you put the two together, their hands form to almost look like they're part of the same picture. It's like, no, there's something to that. But this almost looks like it might be a little, I don't know, not vertical enough and not jagged enough either. Unless we use that window's filter on those flowers. That's an interesting theory that I hadn't considered. Why do I get the feeling the green one is the one that I can't access from below? I think I have to use the elevator. Which stinks, because now I gotta remember all those stupid color puzzles again. This is easily the weakest link for me in my puzzle-solving resume is these stupid color puzzles. I mean, I have a better understanding of them now, but still. Yeah, that's the one that leads up to the green. Of course it is. The one I need. Okay. Let me real quick go through these so that you guys don't have to deal with it again and deal with all my blunders, and I'll be back when we're up in the green floor, because I think that's the key. Okay, so I finally remembered how to do this. It did take me quite a few tries, namely to get this puzzle right, but then also to remember that you have to step off as it's going to get it to trigger. But it paid off, because look at that, we were right. Now, if I can just get this lined up, well, I don't know, this might be the whole puzzle. Oh, I guess it is. Okay, I thought maybe we had to do something where that one tail piece lined up, but I guess not. So we did it. Got that one. Sweet. Which then leads me to believe I'm really, 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 really thinking that one statue puzzle is the one we're missing. I'm really beginning to speculate that. One thing I want to try, I don't know if it'll work or not. But I want to try and go about this a little bit differently in experimentation, if you will. And what I mean by that is trying from different perspectives to see if I can get that puzzle to line up, or rather the statues to line up in a different way than what I've gotten them to do in the past. I'm not 100% sure whether or not that's the right approach. And the reason I say that is because the one puzzle is so small down, or the one statue is so small down here, and it makes me wonder if there's ever a way to go from top to bottom, or if you always have to be looking, you know, bottom to top. Okay, so here's another interesting one to speculate about. And that is this area over here, where I know we've used it to get the purple puzzles down here. You know, we did these. There's one, there's two, and then there's three. So I know that we got those. But I'm wondering, is that all this was here for? There's something with... Wait a minute. I see a circle there that I never saw before. Huh. I hope I'm not going crazy and that others can see that right there. It's not giving me any kind of signal, but it's confirming little at a time that there is a puzzle there. Now, I wonder if I've been looking at this the wrong way. Ironic, considering that it's probably a point of view perspective puzzle. Because from there, I don't see it. Wait, what am I walking? Oh, I can go all the way out here? Fascinating. I don't know that this isn't something that needs to be done while moving, either. That's also a possibility. The only other thing that bothers me a little bit about this is I don't see a scenario where this statue or this one will line up to make a straight line, which is essentially what that puzzle that's left in this area is. Well, basically, that's what it's laid out to be, as a straight line. So, I'm a little apprehensive about saying, yep, we found it, this is it, I just need to line it up right, when I'm dealing with something like that, that really makes me wonder if I'm actually barking up the right tree. I don't think I have to go this way either to get around anymore. I can take that route if I want to go the one way, or I can take this one. Oh, but I still need to use a bridge no matter which way I go, unless I want to go all the way around. Pooh. We did those two. Alright, we'll go the other way, because that's actually a little faster. Believe it or not. It doesn't seem like it, but waiting on those bridges take forever. So I am not planning on waiting on them. Voila! Okay. Now, like I said, I haven't confirmed that there isn't one more in that area right there. But I still just keep coming back to this spot. I know. I'm sure a lot of people are like, yes, I've actually seen you come back to this spot multiple times. I just... There's something to be done here, and I just don't know what it is. Wait a minute. I wonder if somehow their arms make the circle? Interesting. I just can't make sense of how this is lined up. to get it to do anything. That's the only... I've thought about the fence, too. Like, perhaps it's actually the chain link part that you need to line up. But then that becomes a problem with positioning and stuff. But literally, I don't think there's been any reason to come out here on this ledge. Like, there hasn't been any solution or any puzzle to solve out here. So then it leads me to wonder, like, I'm not crazy, I don't think. Or at least not about this. I don't think. Tell you what, let me mess around with this a little bit, and I'm gonna... so I don't waste all my time that's remaining, and see if I can't find something I haven't seen before. Wow. Wow. Talk about a misdirect. Holy crap. Alright, I don't know that I'm wrong about this one, okay? There may actually be something here. Okay? Are we established on that? We got that part going? Okay, good. Because this has nothing to do with the puzzle I'm looking for. I got up here and I didn't actually even realize you could get up here, right? I just was walking around and I was like, oh, hey, you can get up here. And then I'm like, oh, maybe I have to get in the cage and... wait, no, that... no, that's... no, that doesn't do anything. Okay, well, maybe if I go... what is this? By George. I believe it's the puzzle we're looking for. Sort of, in a strange... I gotta get the right perspective, though, apparently, which this is not. To get it to work. Oh, that looks like a half. Hmm. That's interesting. So this is definitely where it is. Yep, there it goes. Okay. Well, the only thing I know to do then is to try... oh, wait a minute. What if it's this way? No, I think I had it right the first time. I'm wondering... if we change this setup, if there's like a piece of this that'll... I don't know. We're gonna figure it out. So for this I've gotta do... like... I forget how to do this one. Like this. Whoops, nope. Like this. There we go. Alright, and then run back over here. Oh, it turns that bridge. Okay. So then at some point while this is turning, this is going to line up for me, I guess. Maybe. Possibly. Oh, there it goes. Alright. So this brings us to a new dilemma. Is, am I actually crazy for thinking that there's something with these two statues? Because for all intents and purposes, there is not. That could be a symbolism thing. There might be an audio log around here somewhere where you're supposed to, you know, stare at the two statues ominously or something. But by the looks of things, that does not actually contain a puzzle like I thought it would. So, that changes some things. So that went a lot more differently than I thought it would. Yeah. So the thing here then becomes, do those two statues have anything to do with the other curved puzzles that we've been looking at that are the remaining puzzles on that obelisk or not? I don't think they do, mainly because they point in a completely different direction, unless it has to do with, the only way I could see that being a thing is if somehow the hands of the statue lined up with certain clouds that then created some form of opportunity. I don't know. Actually, I'm also not really sure where I'm at this point. How do I get out of here? I think this is where I want to go. Maybe? Yes. Okay, good. Got a little lost there for a second. Okay. So we finished these sides. All that's done. This is now done. So the only two remaining puzzles are these two. Which, ironically, because they're a mirror puzzle design, they should actually be relatively easy to find. And I say relative very loosely. I'm thinking clouds, but that's not 100% certain. Nothing in this game is 100% certain at this point, in my opinion. Like, this could go all kinds of ways. I just know it's in the direction towards the bamboo forest. That's all I know. That looks like it could be a thing. But again, perspective and angle and all that stuff, I have no idea where these things are at this point. I've seen no real indications of anything. It can't be too far into the forest area, only because of the fact that it would have been attached to the other obelisk. And I don't think it's back that way towards the other statues, because then, well, it would have been facing the other direction. So, once again, we're in a bit of a bind in terms of finding what I'm looking for. Though, it is possible that it's in the curve of these trees somewhere, somehow. There weren't that many environmental puzzles in this area, actually. Like you, for example. Don't think I don't see you. I see you there. There's one. And, like a good mirror, there's the other. Bam! Just like that, we have solved that whole obelisk now. Which is amazing and awesome. Okay, now, there's good and bad things to this successful endeavor. And I'm going to explain why. Some of you may already be one step ahead of me and know why this is good and why this is bad. Okay? So, first of all, I need to get a good thumbnail shot for this because we got another obelisk! What? Alright, there we go. Okay. Actually, hold on just one second. Sorry about that. When I did that, the button I have for screen grabbing, it did a weird little, brought up like a pop-up thing on my desktop, and I didn't know if the game was actually recording that. I mean, if Fraps was actually recording that, or if it was technically out of the program or not. Because Fraps has this interesting thing where it will only record like the program it's attached to. It won't just record your whole screen. So there are times where things will come up on the screen, but it doesn't actually record it. So I never really know for any huge degree of certainty. So I just wanted to pause for a second and get rid of it and make sure that it wasn't there. Now, we are down to the last obelisk, which is awesome. Now, I do think we have a lot more audio files to find. I don't think we're close to having all of those, but I probably won't do that on camera. My main reason for that is twofold. One, I've already platinumed the game, so by most accounts, we're already kind of, like, completed, but I want to get all the puzzles and hidden stuff, but that's the puzzles. I don't know that the audio logs count towards anything. They're just more narrative and more introspection and all that kind of stuff, so I may not do an audio log hunt kind of thing, because honestly, that could take a long time. They're very well hidden, and there's not a lot to explain where they're hidden at. You just kind of happen across them most of the time. So there's that. But puzzles, panels, hidden things, stuff like that I like to find. The audio logs I'm not super concerned with, if I don't find all of them. But we have one more obelisk, at least. So there is still more to be done. But however, this has formed a problem for me. The problem... Well, now, some of these, not so much. for example, I want to say it was these. I think these were in the videos. Yeah, because this was the leaves in the video. These were the doorways from the first video. This was the second one. And I don't know about the rest of these. So I'm saying probably these at least are going to be in videos, is what I'm guessing. Now we have other videos. I've got other ones that we haven't gone through. I think I have at least one or two screenshots of hex puzzles that I haven't used. So we're only missing one hexagon puzzle. So if we operate on the assumption that these three are related somehow to videos of the hexagon puzzles, then we're left with these two and this one. I think, if that's accurate. So we're left with three that may or may not be, that probably aren't, and then three that may or may not be related to puzzles in the videos. The reason this is a problem is I don't have all the hexagonal puzzles. There is one that has still eluded me, so to speak. And I'm going to head over there now, before we wrap this episode up, just the last little bit, because I want anybody that's just tuning in, or anybody that hasn't commented or something like that, that wants to be aware of the dilemma that I'm facing. Now, we do have other puzzles I could do in the meantime, but ultimately I would kind of like to get this one out of the way, because it's been a thorn in my side ever since I found it. I'm still not 100% sure that this road isn't one of some kind either, but that remains to be seen. And plus, if it was, it probably would have been on the other obelisk right next to the castle, so it's probably not. But like everything in this game, I just start to get suspicious after a while that everything is a puzzle if you look at it right. No, some of you already know this because I brought this up multiple times. If you're just now getting around to this, or you've been binge watching or something, I don't know. You may have not encountered it. But it is what I've referred to as the cargo hauler, cargo freighter door puzzle. That's kind of what I've just started calling it. And it's basically been almost as daunting as trying to do the gauntlet for some reason, just because there's a lot of mechanics involved with it, and I don't know how to process them all properly. I've had a lot of people trying to give me helpful hints in the comments and things, which I appreciate, and at the same time not trying to just, hey, do this, which I also appreciate. I've said that before. I don't mind people hinting or helping, or going, hey, you might want to look over here again because you missed something like that. I'm fine with that. I wanted to be able to say at the end of the day, we did figure them all out. This is the guy. This is a fun one. And I've talked before about the reasons why this has become a problem for me. Mainly because the sounds, I don't seem to find the right amount of sounds in the right pitches and things to line up with all the dots, and so I'm not really sure which dots apply to what sounds. Also, there's these black ones that I don't know what to do with, if you have to do them, or if they're just there to throw you off. I do know that it's an invisible symmetry puzzle, but because neither of the lines match the colors, I don't know which side I'm working with on each one, so I don't know which place I'm actually supposed to be starting with, and so on and so on. So there's a lot of little different pieces in place with this one that has kind of been a thorn. I know for a fact, just because of process of elimination and some creative camera angles in previous episodes, I know for a fact that this is where the other hexagon puzzle is. Mainly for one big reason is that it's one of the few panel puzzles I have left. Most of the other ones are environmental. So this one is not going to give me any it's not going to give me any obelisk puzzles. So with that in mind, I know that it's back here, behind this door. I just don't know how to open this friggin' door. So, again, I haven't quite gotten to the point where I've given up hope to where it's like, just tell me how to do this. I haven't quite gotten to that breaking point yet. I'm still trying to do my darndest to figure it out. This, I think, yeah, that's what gave it away, that safe kind of thing right there. So that's definitely going to be the last hex puzzle. I honestly just don't know how to open the door. So, with that said, I'm going to wrap up this episode here. Feel free to leave your comments on how you would go about solving it or something like that, or maybe ideas that I might be missing. Currently, and here's a good idea. You can point out what I'm doing wrong, because currently, here's what I know. Or what I think I know. I believe this is an invisible symmetry, where when I do this on one side, you're going to do the same thing on the other, but you can't see it. The main evidence is you'll run into the other side if you do something like that. I also know that the shapes or sizes of the dots indicate that it's a sound puzzle, so these sounds going off in the background are things I should be taking note of. Currently, my belief is that the hums, the wah, those kinds of sounds, I think are the pink, and the drip drops I believe to be the orange, because I only ever hear two of those horn type sounds, and I hear three drips, but they sound like three different pitches. So these two being equals throws me off, because I hear three different tones with the water drops. The black ones, I have no idea. I don't know what they're for. I don't hear a third sound, and so I don't know how to factor them in. I'm not sure if they're necessary to solve the puzzle or if they're just to throw you off. I'm not sure if they're supposed to be a different, you know, a uniform color to where you can use them for either puzzle depending on which one works. I don't know that part. So the black ones are a big question mark to me. The other thing that I don't know is some have suggested this red light having to imply a color puzzle within this to where maybe it's not all the right colors. The other problem I face is, like I mentioned, normally when you did a symmetry puzzle like green and orange, when you picked one, you had the orange, so you knew which side you were going for. This one being white, I don't know which side I'm supposed to be using to tackle what. I've tried a bunch of different kinds of ways. I don't really want just a here's a picture, here's a solution type of thing, but I'm open to, you know, whatchamacallit, like vague suggestions and things like that of maybe, have you thought about it like this? You know, stuff like that. And suggestions just on its own. Like, I don't know how to solve it, but have you tried thinking of it like this? Because this is something I thought of. That's fine, too. I'm not quite to the point where I want to give up and just say, no, this is, how do you do this? I've solved most everything else on my own with some helpful hints from people, without blatantly actually just telling me how to do something, and I'd like to say I did the whole game that way. So, with that said, let me know what you guys think in the comments. We at least got another obelisk out of the way, so we are one step closer to having unlocked all of the secrets of the witness. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. In the meantime, I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. Peace.